And the final game of this series is underway here at HP Pavilion in San Jose. The Sharks and the Flames for the right to move on. The starting line is Ryan Clough alongside Patrick Marleau and Joe Pavelski, as the Flames' Jerome McGinley tosses it into the San Jose zone. Now Joe Pavelski moving it up ice for the Sharks. Through traffic, slowed down, gets it in, and now the Sharks will back out of the zone themselves on a delayed offside. Here are the lines and defense pairs for Ron Wilson and the San Jose Sharks. Mahalik, Thornton, and Chichu reunited once again. We'll see if it feels so good. Chris Miller back on the line with Mitchell and Greer. Setoguchi, Gotch, and Roenick making up the fourth line. That means no Jody Shelley tonight and no Curtis Brown tonight.
I would have liked to see Curtis Brown in this lineup, because Curtis is a veteran. He's a leader. He's a guy that can really provide a stabilizing presence and experience at this moment.
So two things come to mind. One, Wilson tried to recreate some of the regular season magic that the Sharks enjoyed when Mahalik, Thornton, and Chichu were together, along with that checking line of Riss Miller, Mitchell, and Greer. Nolan's shot wide as Novakov reached out for it. The other thing that comes to mind is Wilson trying to get some youthful exuberance back in his lineup, bringing Marcel Gotch in and leaving Setoguchi in there. And, of course, the veteran presence of Jeremy Roenick back in the lineup tonight for Game 7 after he was a healthy scratch in Game 6.
Most experience on the San Jose Sharks as far as Game 7s go, plus he's got four Game 7 goals.
This is Roenick's sixth ever Game 7. Owen Nolan with two game winners in the series, but he lost it on the boards. Air hop, and he banks it off the outside of the net.
Looking for Patrick Rissmiller driving towards the net. Nifty little idea.
Cleared down by Calgary for icing. Well, Mike Keenan going with a very similar looking lineup from Game 6. There's the big line. Tange with Lanco and Aginla.
But I really like the third line that they've had. Well, not this line. Sorry. I guess it would be the fourth line. I love Primo with Moss and Nystrom. I thought they were the best line for the Calgary Flames in Game 6. And Wayne Primo, heart and soul guy. Watch out for Robin Regier. He's always going to be lined up against Joe.
Mitchell wins the faceoff, but it's between the defense. Marc-Edouard Vlasic paired with Craig Rive. As Erhoff was just out there last shift. Now Kiprusoff wristing it high off the glass. Knocked down by Greer. And it's around to Stefan Yell for Calgary. Not many people gave the Flames the win in the pre-series predictions. Many said it would go to six or seven games. There's a chance in front for the Sharks as they get bodies in front of Kiprusoff. And that'll be key for both teams tonight, as it always is in these tight games, creating traffic for the goaltenders. And you've got two of the best in the business in this series. Marc-Edouard Vlasic falls, but on the ice, able to make a play to strip Christian Huselius. Now Marcel Gotch. He'll weave toward the Calgary net. Off to the side, he's pushed by Regier, but he comes up with the puck again. Now Jeremy Roenick back for Gotch. Swings it out front. And Huselius able to steal and clear it out for Calgary. But that's a good shift for that group, their first time out on the ice. And they did bring what Wilson wants them to bring, some energy. Now, tonight's Nissan keys to Game 7.
There it is. If you got to ask, you shouldn't be here. The keys to Game 7 are compete, battle, one-on-ones. Do whatever it is you have to do in order to win. Step out of character. Scorer, be a hitter. Hitter, be a scorer. Everything you need to do to win.
Give us your best.
Right.
Every shift. Kiprusoff, a couple of saves. Puck still in the Calgary zone as Rive unable to hold the zone, and now the Sharks will back away as David Hale moves it ahead for the Flames. No score. We play 4 minutes in Game 7. Craig Conroy brings it round the net. A pass off to the side. Huselius stumbles. And now some good work back there by Matt Carl. Sharks get the puck away, but can't get it up ice. Carl. And back to the point. It bounces through beyond Canuck. As Hale is back for Calgary. Patrick Marleau in on the forecheck, but Hale able to turn away from him. Then as he moved the puck, he's checked by Mitchell, but the Sharks don't pick it up in the neutral zone. Lombardia skipper, Novakov mishandled it. He comes back to the San Jose net.
That should have been squashed in the neutral zone. I thought the Sharks D backed up when they didn't need to.
Now Marleau trying to move it up for Greer, but he's hit hard by Vandermeer. Now Greer comes back, makes the play, and chips it around Adrian Acoin. Here's Mike Greer, but Acoin got a stick on it late. Mitchell comes in, picks it up, but Lombardi's right on him. Now Greer and Mitchell grinding it out in the corner against the Calgary D. Greer turns it over, and Lombardi will send it ahead.
Watch guys coming off the bench here.
David Moss, and Ehrhoff gives him a rough ride. Greer follows with a hit as well. Wayne Primo, the former Shark, trying to dig it out. And now the Sharks defense with control. First ever game seven here in San Jose. The Sharks have been in five of them, of course, all on the road. And just to give you an idea of what home ice really means, well, not that much in game sevens, at least in the ones the Sharks have played, because they have a winning record in game seven, 3-2.
But overall, it has been a stat that has favored the home team, almost a .600 winning percentage in the playoffs.
Setoguchi now for the Sharks. He'll lob a pass ahead, but it'll go behind the net. Jeremy Roenick there after it. Ian Regier in the corner that time. And now Lanko comes ahead and feeds to Ginla. His shot turned aside by Nabokov. Long stretch pass up for Setoguchi, isolated against Benoit. Thornton comes in, takes the pass. Benoit had fallen, but then Thornton mishandled the pass. Vlasic in front, Chichu, and it bounced off a skate wide.
Just healed it a little bit.
Craig Ribe winds, fires, saved by Kiprasov. And the Flames have the rebound. Jerome Ginla, their captain, sending it up ice. Vlasic trying to find a bouncing puck before Tongue did, and he comes up with it to Milan Mihalik.
The Sharks should feel confident about the start that they've had in this game. They are putting the pressure on the Calgary Flames, and the Flames right now are playing a little bit of chase.
5-2, the shots in favor of the Sharks. Tange skates in, delays, and Mihalik with a strong back check takes it away. Now Nolan back out front for Hale, and it deflects high back into the corner for Owen Nolan. Two game winners in this series for Nolan, including a huge goal in game six on Sunday in Calgary. Trip away from the play as Pavelski was upended. No call. Here's Nolan at the point. Ehrhoff stopped him first time. Now Nolan gets it deep.
But that's the kind of thing you have to be able to overcome in the playoffs. The referee, if they make a call or don't make a call, you have to be able to have that composure to get over it and move on and overcome.
A coin back as Pavelski leads with a hit. Flo losing his edge down low as Christian Huselius works it back and forth to the D. Hale, the long pass in for Yell. Nabokov will stop it behind the net. He'll send it up the boards for Marlowe, and Patrick gets it cleared. And the breakout as Ryan Clough chips it in. Marlowe will pursue it. Saric on it first. He's the Calgary Flame defenseman, of course, who dished out that thundering hit on Marlowe in game three in the midst of Calgary's incredible comeback in this series when they fought off a 3-0 deficit early. Patrick Rissmiller in the zone alone gets it deep now as the Sharks change up behind the play. It's game seven. If the Sharks win this, they will open up at home against the Dallas Stars later this week. Marcel Gotch sending it in, and Rissmiller after the puck against Benoit. Nice play by the Calgary defenseman there.
You got to get in there quick as the second man.
Eric Nystrom put down by Setoguchi.
Good play by Devin Setoguchi. Offside. Joe Thornton, Jonathan Chichu, Milan Mihalik. Those are the big names, the big guns on the San Jose Sharks. That line, you know, the Sharks coaching staff, they talked over Milan Mihalik. And what Ron Wilson told Milan was, hey, listen, you're a great player, kid. Just do what comes naturally. Use your wheels. Drop that shoulder. Go to the net. Just be yourself. Don't overthink it. And I think that's great advice. Simplify your game when you're having trouble.
As a player internally, though, you have to decide to make a contribution in a game like this. And whether it's a goal or whether it's what we saw earlier on a strong back check
right
by Mihalik, you've got to make a difference in a game like this.
And he already did. Exactly. That's a great point, Randy, with that good back check taking away a very good scoring chance.
Thornton battling. He batted it ahead with his glove, but the Flames touch it first. And Regier will send it all the way back down the ice. Icing waved off as it was deflected up at center. Campbell, a quick swing out pass and a nice execution, but then Mihalik mishandled it coming off the boards. Thornton brings it in. He'll turn. Saucer pass up the middle for Clough, a bouncer, And Sharks couldn't do anything with it there. It's Owen Nolan now. Slips a hit from Klo, but enough of a hit to get the puck away. And Klo gets it back down into the Calgary zone. He's got it now, moving to the net. A passing shot and a penalty coming up to Calgary.
Erickson's going to get two for hooking. Ryan Klo with a strong move along the boards to create that scoring chance. And that is what you're talking about when you're talking about creating opportunities where there may be none. Ryan Klo, strong guy, chips the puck by Erickson, just bulls past him. Hook on the arms, still using his feet, gets the puck to the front of the net. Good job by Patrick Marleau going in. Here's the first opportunity for the Sharks with the man advantage.
The Sharks power play brought to you by Rambus. Calgary's penalty kill ranked third in the NHL in these playoffs. It's been good. The Sharks power play has generated four goals so far, but they haven't been nearly quite so efficient as they'd like to be. Maybe it can change here in Game 7. Pavelski all the way around now to the point, and Campbell's there.
The pressure.
Pavelski able to hold it into Ribe. Ribe to the front, tipped toward the net by Patrick Marleau, but Kristoff able to make a save. There wasn't much on that. And now Lombardi, and watch out for him. He was a great shorthanded goal scorer in the regular season.
And that's what you do in order to combat that pressure. You move it quick from side to side. You had some guys caught for a good chance on net.
Now Roenick out on the power play. He'll come across the Calgary line with it. He's tripped up by a coin. No call. Back to Ribe now on this side. He'll give it to Thornton. Joe, a shot. Oh, deflected by Roenick. And it just took a bad angle off the deflection wide of the net.
Good play by Joe Thornton looking for the stick. Jeremy Roenick recognized, sat up in front, and almost got the first goal of the game.
Now Matt Paul. And he'll drive it in off the glass from center. It ricochets around into the corner. Chichu posted up against the coin. Now to Thornton behind the net. He gets a rough ride from the coin, but the Sharks hold the puck. Chichu in front to Thornton. He's got Joe Thornton! And it's 1-0 San Jose!
Take advantage of the aggressiveness. Two guys going after Joe Thornton. That means you're going to have a chance to outnumber him in front of the net. Good puck movement. Two guys, three guys going to Jonathan Chichu. So that aggressiveness of the Calgary Flames is beaten by quick puck movement by the San Jose Sharks. That's the way you beat an aggressive penalty kill. And the Sharks get that big first goal.
You could argue that it's the biggest game of Joe Thornton's NHL career. Always under the microscope in the postseason. And so many questioning him. Of course, most of those don't see him as much as we do. How can you question a former MVP scoring leader? But the questions have always been about the playoffs for Joe, and he answers some of those questions with a big goal right there. Now here's Mike Greer. His backhand shot blocked by Kiprasov, and he will hold it there. Thornton with his second goal of these playoffs. It gives the Sharks the lead in Game 7.
Joe Thornton with the big power play goal gives the Sharks the first goal of the game, an important Game 7 on the power play. Great pass by Jonathan Chichu. Beats David Hale. And Joe Thornton takes his time and puts it upstairs. Check it out. Thornton gets across. Make sure he got it on a stick, and then he rifles it. From the net cam, Mika Kiprasov with the big stretch, but Joe Thornton with the better shot. Jeremy Roenick, who gets an assist. Yeah, he likes that. We talked to JR in the pregame show. He's an important factor in this game big time because that experience has paid off for the Sharks.
The 66th playoff assist for Jeremy Roenick in his outstanding NHL career. Kiprasov a save. Here's Klo. A shot. It's blocked by Regier. The Sharks want more here in the first period. They're up 1-0 on the power play goal by Thornton. There's a shot from the point coming in. Off a deflection back to the corner. Saric will play it up. And now the Flames at center ice trying to get something going for themselves here.
I'll tell you what, Corey Sarge cannot get rid of that puck fast enough, and Ryan Klo's on the ice.
Here's Klo, and he'll send it over the open wing. Chichu and Roenick got the assist. Thornton's goal, his second of these playoffs, and 11th of his Stanley Cup playoff career. And we've got a penalty coming up here.
It's every time Corey Sarge gets the puck, Ryan Klo's right on top of him.
It's going to be against the Sharks.
Holding penalty, Milan Mihalik on Owen Nolan, I do believe it was, but it was a holding penalty. One more time, actually on Rob McGeer. You see Milan wrap the arm around the right arm of Robin McGeer. So here is another critical moment in the hockey game in the first period. That power play for the Flames that's been so, so good. And the penalty killers who used to be so, so good.
Here's Dion Phaneuf. Nolan gives it back to him. Now a coin. They score. And the power play comes through again for Calgary. And it's 1-1.
I mean, it's not even tough for the Flames anymore to score on that power play. It is amazing how a penalty-killing unit who was the best and was awesome at it are getting beat all the time. This shot's going to go off the net. You're going to have a Gintler crash towards the net with a great deflection. Nice setup, how the Flames like to spread out their D and get that shot on net. And that's terrific hand-eye coordination by a Gintla to get that deflection in a very awkward place and tip it in the net.
So a Gintla with his fourth goal of this series. A coin will get the primary assist. I think they're just checking to make sure it didn't go off his hands.
Yeah, they're also Mike Keenan's doing his usual stuff, as Tim Hunter likes to say, muddying the waters with the change. He tried to change again, and he's not allowed to, and Ron Wilson wanted to call him on that.
So Mahalik's holding penalty costs. The goal is good, and we're set to drop the puck with this game tied right back up. Both goals on the power play. Calgary scores on only their third shot of the game. And now they come ahead again. 3-0 to Nolan. Owen Nolan throwing it back toward the San Jose net. Now Campbell in a race on this side. Takes the hit to get to the puck. And Douglas Murray will bring it up ice. On to Klo. And they go offside.
One of the aspects of a game seven is that you're going to have switches in momentum. You're going to have a game slide from side to side, and you've got to wrestle the momentum back once it has been taken away from you. So in this game, we got pushing and shoving. And we're going to have guys going now. Ryan Klo's going to go. Jim Vandermeer should go with that little face wash and see if the referee's got any courage to call what should be called.
He's just going to even it up. So Nolan and Ryan Klo will sit for two each.
And that's the muddying of the waters that Tim Hunter talks about when it comes to a Mike Keenan coached team. Anyway, going back to the momentum situation, what you have to be able to do is once momentum is taken from you, stolen from you, you got to steal it right back. And you do that through going back out, staying with your game plan, going to the body, doing the little things that get you back in the game.
12:46, two each for roughing. They skate 4-on-4. 1-1 the score. Goals by the two big dogs. Scott Thornton for the Sharks. Iginla for the Flames. And now Greer with some speed on the wing and some room now. 4-on-4. To the net. And poked by Kiprusoff. Almost into his own net off Ehrhoff.
Good read by Ehrhoff to jump to the net. Almost caught Dion Phaneuf on that aggressive pinch in the neutral zone.
Vandermeer sending it in for Calgary as Ehrhoff back defensively. And again, took the hit to make the play, but now Gotch getting in trouble on the board.
That should just come straight out of his zone. I think the Sharks every once in a while get caught wearing that puck possession game. Played a little bit too much. You sometimes can get yourself into problems with it.
Now Thornton at center. Big Joe turning the corner. Try to swing a backhand pass through. Good job by Regier to block it and then take Thornton out in the corner. Craig Conroy picking it up. Mahalik on the back check, but he skates through it.
Late guys coming up.
Conroy, a wrister, and Nabokov's going to hold on to it. 51 seconds left in the offsetting minor penalty.
You really have to watch the late attack with the Calgary Flames. The D will jump up and the... They'll jump up on that play. Sarge jumped up initially, and then Tanguay was jumping as well, so it was almost a 3-on-2.
That goal by Iginla was Calgary's sixth power play goal of this series. They're now 6-for-21. That's over 25%.
Yeah, and listen, it just comes down to the fact that the Sharks have to do a much better job. You've got to find a way.
Well, it starts with winning the faceoff right away. And right from the draw, the Sharks were in a hole as they gave up possession. As they do here, Phaneuf over to Erickson. Now Anders Ericsson sliding it back down the boards.
You've got to be aggressive in this situation.
Putting up a blast, and Nabokov got a piece of that.
I don't like how the Sharks play that contained game on a 4-on-4.
Here's Mahalik with a chance to go wide on Phaneuf. Thornton picks it up. Mahalik getting it back to the point for Ribe. He'll wrist one into traffic, but it's blocked by the Flames. And now Stefan Yell comes ahead. He's got Lombardi busting the zone with him. Ryan Campbell will get to it in the corner. Game 7. We've played just over 14 minutes. It's a 1-1 tie. Sharks scored first from Thornton. Aginla tied it up, both of them on the power play. And the Sharks are offside on a very shaky entry. Back comes Hale to the Flames. He'll get it deep to Douglas Murray, unfortunately for him. Now Flow to Pavelski with some speed through the middle. Pass for Marlowe, broken up by Lanco. As Hale sends it over to a coin. Calgary, good work in their own end on that ship. And now Lanco comes back into the Shark zone to a coin. And that'll deflect off Pavelski's stick. Out of play as we step aside. Tied at 1 here in the first period. Calgary's top line matched by the Sharks' best defensive line as the draw comes back through the middle and to Douglas Murray. Chris Miller, Mitchell, and Greer out there. And throughout the regular season, they were the best at shutting down the opposition. Also, critical penalty killers as well. They've got a tough task here against Aginla and company as Aginla brings it in. Pulls up, and then Mitchell's there to steal it and send it in for Chris Miller. He'll try and bust his way past Erickson. Erickson losing an edge. Mitchell came in, overskated it, but Rissmiller's got it. And he'll swing it back down toward the goal. Erickson gave Mitchell a shove, knocked him off the puck. Now Ron Wilson changing on the fly, sends his top line on. Thornton with the puck into the middle. Chichu bounces to his stick, then comes to Mahalik. Milan Mahalik out of the corner, brings it round the net. Back to the point. Erhoff gives it to Vlasic on his backhand. Has to send it off the boards down the ice. Wristed up ice by the Flames. And it's Lanco with it, but Mahalik digs in there along with Thornton trying to keep it going for the Sharks.
Good work by Milan.
Vlasic. Thornton lost it, but Chichu's there. Pursued by Phaneuf, who hangs on to him. And there'll be a penalty here to Calgary. First, here's Thornton. A shot by Vlasic, saved by Kiprasov, and we get the penalty to Dion Phaneuf.
And it's a double whammy for Mike Keenan's team because you've got a great penalty killer in Dion Phaneuf sitting in the box for 2 minutes. Jonathan Chichu gets body position, keeps working. Definitely Dion Phaneuf grabbed on him just like the Mahalik call. Joe Thornton slides, looking for an opportunity. Coming back, supporting the puck.
Campbell to the net and hit the outside of the goalpost. Now Ryan Close trying to settle things down as he gets it over to Ribe. Back down and around, all the way to where Owen Nolan's positioned, and he's able to wrist it clear. So the Sharks come back out and regroup as Pavelski finds Klo open. Ryan Klo to Marlowe. Patrick down the wing, sends it back to the point, D to D, over to Campbell. Ribe fakes his shot. Campbell will go to the wing now for Pavelski. Trying to set up Campbell for the one-timer, it wasn't there. Now Marlowe, nobody on this point to go to, so he sends it deep to Klo. Back to Marlowe. Patrick skates it forward to Klo. Now to Campbell. Over to Ribe. A slap pass, and it doesn't work out as Yell reads it and clears it down with a minute gone on the power play.
I like the puck movement. I think there's a couple opportunities, though, where the Sharks passed up on being aggressive with a move to the net.
Matt Carl takes the handoff from Campbell. Roenick on the wing to Thornton, and it took a bounce off his stick out of play.
That though, Jeremy Roenick and Joe Thornton looking like they've developed a little chemistry with the man advantage. Joe Thornton is all over the puck, and Jeremy Roenick is certainly getting himself in position to make the plays.
45 seconds left in Dion Phaneuf's penalty.
Dion
yards back for Calgary. And that takes a Flames bounce right to Lombardi. Now Carl handling it carefully. And he'll send it back around for Erhoff. 1:15 left in the first period. As Thornton wrists it in hard. After it on that far side is Roenick, but again it takes a bad bounce for the Sharks. And it's shot off the netting by Saric on a deflection, and that means it'll come outside the zone because it hit a Shark stick last.
Fortunately, the bounce for the Calgary Flames, and that the draw goes outside. Corey Saric, who has won a Stanley Cup with the Tampa Bay Lightning, playing against these Calgary Flames, came over a free agent deal.
Campbell back to retrieve it with a minute to go in the period. Time running down on the power play. 8 seconds to go. He'll get it to Thornton, but Joe couldn't enter the zone in time to get it on the fly. Kikyu able to recover it. Roenick working behind the net. Kikyu moves in front. There's the pass. Here's Thornton trying to jam it through. It's open! Kipras off down, able to come up with a stop as he lost his stick, but still made the save.
He loses stick.
Here are the Flames. Higginlon shoots in the bottom with a save. That's the shot similar to that that Damon Lanko scored on in Game 6, going short side on Nabokov. But Nabokov with that, nothing of it there. Erhoff double-teamed in the corner, but good support from Mitchell coming forward. 10 to go in the period as he tosses it up ice for Rissmiller. Regier's back on it for Calgary to Higginlon. He's got Tange with him, but the pass is out of the reach of Lanko, and that's going to do it for the first period of Game 7. Here we go, the last playoff round still alive in the opening round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. As earlier tonight, Philadelphia advanced with a victory in overtime over Alexander Ovechkin and company in Washington. Flames with the puck here, and a block by Marlowe, and now Klo hands it to Joe Pavelski. He'll fake, go through the middle with Klo, and Marlowe takes a swing at it, but banned on the puck.
I think Regier's foot got in the way, unfortunately, for Patrick Marlowe.
Oh, Nolan ahead for Primo, and he'll get it deep to the corner. Primo and Vlasic battling. Primo comes out with the puck. It skips to the net, and Nabokov, a nifty save.
Now, the Flames don't score many pretty goals. They grind them out. They do whatever it takes to get the pucks in that. Usually, you know, with this Daryl Sutter general managed team, they're a team that wants to get into the forecheck and create loose puck opportunities, throw it to the net and jam away. Look at this puck. It's skipping all over the place, and it ends up in a scoring chance.
Both top lines on the ice right now. Thornton and company for the Sharks. Higginla and friends for the Flames.
Tell you a guy who's impressed me in this series, too. Jim Vandermeer, number 4.
Blanco over the line to Higginla. Has a look, takes a shot. Nabokov the save, and no rebound.
Sharks, when they are playing against this line on the rush, I think the Sharks are too passive. I think they got to stand up, be aggressive. You have to contest your blue line. On a 2-on-2, you don't need to be backing up. On a 3-on-3, you don't need to be backing up. With a 2-on-3, you don't need to be backing up. Stand up, contest your line. Do not let Joe McGinley get that shot towards the net.
And he wins the draw here, but it comes back toward Thornton. He doesn't get hold of it. Pinball's back in front. And Joe's able to scoop it off to the side. Turns back, gives it for Campbell, but he's forechecked by Lanko. And Calgary gets the puck back. Now Mahalik in the right place at the right time. Able to get it away, but he's shouldered off the puck by Higginla easily. Calgary coming out here and setting the tempo to start this second period. Now it's in deep to Kiprusoff. Sliding it across to Dion Phaneuf. The 23-year-old phenom defenseman for the Calgary Flames. Carl back for an icing touch.
Matt Carl getting his first taste of a Game 7. Not his first taste of the playoffs, but Matt's first Game 7.
Of course, when you're in college hockey, as he was, and you get to the NCAA tournament, every game is a Game 7 because it's single elimination. So the pressure games are in his repertoire.
Absolutely. Oh, good chance there.
Right off the draw, and it came off the inside of Kiprusoff's skate on that follow shot.
Wow, that almost went in. That's from winning the draw and just putting the puck towards the net. That's a simple little play. I like that play.
Chris Miller gets it down out of his glove and a nice pass to Mitchell. Hale is back. Mitchell trying to put on the brakes, lost his edge, and he lost the puck. Kuseli is sending it back down the other way, but icing's waved off as the Flames change up on the fly. 1-1 here in Game 7. That's tipped in by Gotch as Ron Wilson sends his fourth line on for a shift. Adrian Coyne to David Moss. Challenging Ehrhoff. Ehrhoff losing his stride in front and a chance for Nystrom. Now poked away by Roenick. And he's got a break down the left side. Setoguchi trailing. Here's Gotch. Puts it on the net and it's turned aside by Kiprasov. Quick change up ice by the Sharks. And the Flames almost turn it over in their own zone. Now the Sharks do get it back for a moment, but it's pushed ahead. And Nystrom will flick it down as Calgary will change up the rest of their unit. 3 minutes gone here in the second period of Game 7. Marlowe down the wing. Shot saved by Kiprasov. Big rebound right to Craig Conroy. Now he comes ahead with Nolan and the defenseman Corey Sarich. Murray's back. And he'll get it up the boards. Klo now trailing. Able to get it ahead. Marlowe as Klo busts for the net. But Marlowe's pass hit Sarich in the skate. And here's a breakaway for Owen Nolan. He comes in on goal. And scores. And the former Sharks captain gives Calgary the lead, 2-1.
Turnover at the offensive blue line. Not a good read by Douglas Murray. Owen Nolan is the man that's got nothing but getting a block off in front of him. Right there, tries to get it through, doesn't get it through. Flames outnumber the Sharks. No way Douglas Murray should have stepped up there. He should have read the play. Instead, Owen Nolan walks in, gets the shot. What happens? It goes off his leg. You want to talk about an ugly goal? You want to talk about driving the net and just getting something lucky happening? Now it goes in off his skate. Was it a distinct kicking motion?
Let's wait and see. They're going to have to look at this. Very hard to tell from the first replay we saw, but obviously there's going to be a review of this.
And they review that right away. Let's have one more look. Stop. Leg.
Well, it looked like it was kicked in. Definitely went in off his foot.
Definitely went in off his leg, without a doubt. I think sweeping that back leg is what they will be looking at from the National Hockey League. The back leg, the right leg. Watch. He's going to sweep that right leg towards the net, and you can see that it looks like
he
extends
off. He turned the ankle at the end, and that looks like a kicking motion to me.
Absolutely. I agree with you on that one. He said, you can see Owen right there. He may have also hurt himself on that play because he did extend his leg in order to get that puck in the net.
And I wouldn't be surprised if this one takes a little longer than normal, as they want to make sure, obviously, in a Game 7 to get this call absolutely right.
This is the best look right here. Shot, save. Now watch the right leg, how he's going to just follow it through. See how he extends that leg? And that actually clips his ankle.
They're calling it a good goal.
Oh, boy, that surprises me because that looks like he definitely tried to kick that in. I am surprised that the National Hockey League looked at that and reviewed that as a good goal.
So Nolan scores his third of this series. And boy, have all three been big. And now Calgary, at least for the moment, have taken this crowd out of it a bit. 2-1 Flames.
This is when your crowd has to respond. It's that energy and ask the crew. This is where the energy can really help support your team when they had a tough thing go against them.
And they are starting a chant here as Thornton is getting the business from Panuk. Campbell not looking very sure-handed on that pass from Murray. And they'll try it again from this side. Murray up ice to Thornton. Joel bring it in. Now gets wide, allows his wingers to get to the net. Working against him is Lombardi. Mahalik comes in for support. Joe to Chichu. Now here's Carl to the net and parried aside by Kiprasov. Thornton trying to reach Ribe at the point. He'll go all the way down. Novakov. And that doesn't go anywhere, but onto a Calgary stick eventually, and now offside. The goal for Owen Nolan, his third of this series. Huselius and Conroy, the assist at 3:33.
I'm sorry. There's, you're gonna have a tough time convincing me that he didn't kick that in. And the National Hockey League looked at it. I guess it was, they don't think it was definitive, but I think on that angle that we showed you, you saw him extend his leg for a kicking motion.
Almost to the net off of Carl's skate. And the Sharks look shaken here by that Nolan goal. Chris Miller puts it on net. Follow shot by Greer. That's high and wide. Back to Chris Miller. Now Greer behind the goal. Trying to get it to the front. He does. Loose there. Now Greer trying to take it on the wing, but it's Nolan. Back the other way for Calgary. And Carl gets it off him. Nolan driving it in. And Vlasic on the far side, fanning on it. Nabokov's going to have to deal with this now as Roenick settles it. Up ice for Setoguchi. He'll send it in. Gotch against Erickson. And Anders Erickson back with the puck for Calgary. Here's Conroy. Turns it right back over. Roenick waiting for his line mates to get onside. Erhoff. He'll lob one up ice. In front of Erickson, and a round pass put up to Nolan. Back to the middle again. Roenick to the net. They score! Devin Setoguchi! And we're tied again.
Great response from the San Jose Sharks. Jeremy Roenick throws it to the net. Devin Setoguchi. Did he get it or not? Looks like he may have touched it, but Jeremy Roenick made the play. Between the pads, squeaks through. Jeremy Roenick hustling on the puck. Always tracking the puck. Gets it, throws it back towards the net. Boom, it's in. Big celebration. JR's been in on both goals.
Here's another chance at the side for Pavelski. Now cleared out. Good back check by Joe Pavelski as he fires it back in. Devin Setoguchi gets his first ever Stanley Cup playoff goal. And it comes here in Game 7. Assist from Roenick and Erhoff at 6:04. Now a Gidlin. And he blows a tire. Gets back up. Puck's there. Campbell running into Gidlin. Puck free to Marlowe and Patrick. To Pavelski. Back to Marlowe off a bad pass that hit a skate with Clow. And he tried to get it to the point man. Thornton coming through late. It was broken up by Gidlin.
The Sharks have just got to start getting pucks on net on those attacks. A little bit more straightforward.
They're out shooting Calgary 20-8. Nolan, a little flip for a coin to Hyselius. Now Calgary with speed coming through the middle. Hyselius for Conroy. And a good stop there by Vlasic as Thornton comes back the other way. Regier backing in against him, and he stands Thornton up and takes the puck away.
Oh, you saw two good defensive plays there. Look at Joe Thornton keeping on that puck.
Good pursuit. Sharks come up with it. Mahalik to the net. And a deflection by Chichu. He draws a penalty.
Good play by the Sharks. All made possible because Joe Thornton kept pursuing the puck. Devin Setoguchi ties the game up for the San Jose Sharks. There's Marcel Gotch jumping in, making a play, being physical, putting the hit. Jeremy Roenick slides back, throws it towards the net. What does Devin do? He goes right to the front of the net. Gotta love that. That's exactly what you want guys to do. Here's Joe Thornton pursuing Robin Bergier after Robin made a good defensive play. Take it to the net. Craig Conroy. It's Jonathan Chichu down. Draws two for interference.
Third power play of the game for the Sharks. They're 1-for-2. That was the game's first goal from Thornton, and they have it off the faceoff. Craig Rive. He's had a good shot from the point tonight. Back over to Thornton. Joe gets it flat. Dishes to the front. Kipris off the block. Still alive. Behind the net. Blow back over to Marlowe. Now to Campbell. Begs off the shot. Rive will take it. And it's blocked by Lombardi wide. And cleared to the point. And Yell just drives Rive out of the zone. And the puck too.
bulldogs him to the ice. Craig Rive looks like he might be shaken up. Maybe he hit his head on the boards. Maybe he hit his head on the ice.
That's one way of getting the puck out, isn't it?
One more time. Let's have a look at it. Yell was really driving hard. Drives him down to the ice. Pile drives him to the ice, really.
Rive stays out there. And again, off the faceoff, Sharks have it. Campbell goes across right into the feet of Nolan. A no-look play. And rather dangerous. Now he comes up the middle and gets it into Thornton cleanly. To Marleau, and his shot to flex high. And Patrick had it in his wheelhouse, didn't he?
Sure did. It almost looked like that goal from the fifth game of this series where Patrick jumped in and wired one. But I think Owen Nolan with the stick was able to deflect it. One more time. Yeah, Owen Nolan comes across in his stick, but Patrick Marleau in that position with that great release is able to get one on that, but Owen made the good defensive play.
O'Halloran with some business to take care of there, and now we'll have a change in the faceoff circle as Roenick will step in. And he gets the draw. Rive quickly to Thornton, a dart over to Campbell, but he mishandled it. Roenick again across the grain. And it's Rive to Thornton.
Right in front.
Joe looking for somebody in front. As you said, no one home. Now out to the point, Rive to Campbell. Roenick. 35 coming up on the power play. There's the shot through traffic. Roenick scores! Jeremy Roenick! He scores! And it's 3-2!
Mike Keenan looks on. Old player gets a shot at it. What a rebound. And why is there the rebound there? Because Jeremy Roenick makes it happen. He's got people in front of the net. Just put it on the net. There's the rebound. And I didn't think it got to Kiprusoff the first time. But there was enough traffic there that the Sharks were able to grab that loose puck, jack it upstairs. And now you've got the Sharks regaining the lead. That's that momentum swing back and forth that you have to be able to take advantage of.
Jeremy Roenick playing in his sixth career Game 7. That's his fifth Game 7 goal.
He is a big game player. That's how he's made his bones in the National Hockey League.
So the Sharks regain the lead that they gave up earlier in this period. 3-2 now as we are upon the middle parts of regulation at 10:40 left here in the second. Vlasic setting it up the boards, not deep enough. And now here comes Zagrinla. He'll toss it to the corner for Tanguay. Vlasic there first, plays it up, but Lenko gets it. Back for Tanguay. And Rissmiller trying to get it clear, does, over the stick of Pinot.
Huge shift right here. The Flames always want to come up with their top line after they get scored on.
Nice knockdown out of the air by Vlasic. And they'll call it for the high stick touch. Sharks had 39 shots in Game 1 and lost. They outshot Calgary 39-23 in that one. 43 shots, though, in Game 2, and that was enough to beat Calgary 2-0. Out shooting them 43-21. Battle down in the Calgary zone, and Thornton with the puck. Joe slips it through. He's got Campbell over to Murray. Murray takes it off the boards, fires it into the net. There's another shot, and Kiprusoff with a glove save off Douglas Murray.
And that's all from the forecheck, and Douglas Murray gets a rebound opportunity. The Flames doing a good job blocking shots. But Mike Keenan, though, seeing his team taking a lot of shots, as in absorbing a lot. Jonathan Chichu got in the forecheck and was able to make things happen. Jonathan, again, there's a guy, you know, just working hard. You know, he's can't find the net yet. So what does he do? Gets in there in the forecheck. Two men outnumber the Flames for that opportunity.
Right from the draw, Carl to the net, and that pinballs off Conroy wide. And Huselius now took a big hit along the boards from Klo. As Carl hands it back off to Rive.
That was close to a tripping penalty.
3-2 Sharks lead here in Game 7. Leve, nice up for Pavelski. And he'll send it deep now. Kiprusoff out into that trapezoid. He gave it away to Marlow. And then made a recovery play to knock down the pass that was destined for the front of the net.
Slam dunk. Slam dunk opportunity. That's a good recovery.
Chipped in by Conroy. And here's Carl. Moving it to Pavelski, up ice for Klo to Rissmiller. Nice entry into the zone. And then Rissmiller to the net. In and out of the glove of Kiprusoff. Back up ice comes David Moss for Calgary. Lombardi gets it over to Yell. Back for Matthew Lombardi. Nice play against Rissmiller. Gets it to the net. And now Rissmiller able to poke it clear on this side.
Good play by Lombardi.
Loose puck to Mitchell, on to Greer. Mike Greer slips it past a man at the line, and he drew a penalty. Robin Regier's going to go. That'll be interference against the Flames defenseman.
Well, power plays have been important. Use the chip. Yeah, Robin Regier just gets too much of a piece of him. He tries to get a little bit to slow Mike Greer down, but he gets too much of him, and now the Sharks have another huge opportunity on the power play, which has been dangerous tonight.
Sharks are 2-for-3 with 7 power play shots. From the draw, this time the Flames able to get it right down with authority as it's slapped clear by Finot. Brian Campbell will take it. Joe Thornton as Conroy comes across to pressure him. Nice pass to Marlow. Patrick Roenick. And that's blocked off escape, but kept in by Campbell. He'll bounce one to the net. Kicked aside by Kiprusoff. And now Owen Nolan. But it's taken from him by Campbell. Nolan diving to try and get it out. And then Putup finally does. And you see the extra effort in everyone's effort tonight here in Game 7. Thornton down behind the goal line. Trying to center it. Roenick sends it back deep behind the net. And Phaneuf there. And it'll just come out past Campbell. And here comes Conroy with Nolan. Owen Nolan cutting to the middle against Campbell. Oh. Campbell blocking, and it's shoveled to the net but deflected. Here's another shot, and Nabokov with the save. He'll give it back to Campbell.
And Campbell got away with a trip on Conroy.
Campbell across the other side. Sharks were on a change. And Thornton's pass gobbled up by Erickson.
We got to settle things down on this power play. Just take a breath, relax for a minute. Go back to doing things that work. Quit trying to make it up as you go along.
Here's Ryan Klo. To Pavelski. He'll get it in. And get to it first. Klo in the corner. Banks it back. Airhop wise. Fires out of the glove of Kiprusoff. Chichu on it in the corner. Down to Pavelski. Klo to Pavelski again to Airhop. Reaching out. And he does just keep it in the zone. Off Chichu's mitt. Now down to Klo in the corner. Wrapped up by Corey Saric. Chichu helping out. Gets it back high to Airhop. Down to Chichu. Fakes the shot. Lets it go. Just too high. Penalty's over as Regier comes on. Klo back to the point for Airhop. He'll get it off to the wing for Greer. Pavelski scores! Joe Pavelski makes it 4-2.
Greer coming on the ice. The play is made down low. Ryan Klo working hard against two Flames, chips it out to the point. Airhoff waits, spots Greer coming in wide. Nobody picks him up, and that's enough of a block by Corey Saric. And that quick stick. Saric makes a nice play by blocking that play to the net. Pavelski with the quick stick on Nystrom. Lifts the stick and scores. And look what Mike Keenan is doing now.
Goaltending change, and here comes Curtis Joseph.
It worked once in this series. Can it work again for the old cagey coach?
Assisted by 25 Greer. And 10 off time of the goal. 14-01.
So Kiprusoff takes a seat for now on the Calgary bench. Curtis Joseph, who was one of the heroes of Game 3 when the Sharks blew a 3-0 lead. And Joseph came in 3.5 minutes into the game, never gave up a goal.
This is a huge shift right here, right now. You can't take a penalty, and you can't give up a goal.
One of the things I thought the Sharks didn't do was put enough pucks on Curtis Joseph in Game 3. We'll see what they do here. They already have 30 shots in this game. And they lead 4-2. Broken up by Rhys Miller. He'll send it ahead. Here's the speedy Torrey Mitchell. He needs support on the wing. Greer's coming, but late.
Chip everything deep right here. This would be a good shift to do that. It's the right line to have out the ice.
Mitchell back on it again. Around for Rhys Miller behind the net. Rive on the point. He'll send it back again. Setoguchi there now. Takes it, moves it to the net. And Kiprus, or Joseph rather, with the save. Back to Setoguchi again. He scores!
It's a big shift, and once again it happens because the Sharks do the job with Jeremy Roenick on the forecheck. Jeremy Roenick keeps the puck in. Devin Setoguchi picks it up. Second shot beats Curtis Joseph, short side, off the post and in, and that's a huge goal. Huge goal.
5-2 Sharks. But we've seen that a 3-goal lead in this particular series can be very dangerous for the team that has it. Let's see how Game 7 continues to unfold, but a most unlikely second period, as you can imagine. 5 goals, 4 of them by the San Jose Sharks. They lead it 5-2 here in Game 7 on Comcast Sportsnet Bay Area.
After he blocked that shot, he needs a new one.
Face off, and it's Douglas Murray. Over to Vlasic, up for Thornton. Now a pass from Milan Mihalik. He gets through the defense. And Saric, a good job to stay with him as the officials allowed the Calgary defense just to slow up Mihalik enough. No penalty on the play. And fairly so as Murray back behind the net against Owen Nolan. Gets a little crossed up. Now Thornton will bank it back around for Brian Campbell. They have changed the second goal. In fact, Setoguchi did not touch it. So he does have his first playoff goal. He just doesn't have his first two. And Jeremy Roenick will get credit for that goal. He has 2 goals and 2 assists here in Game 7.
I'm surprised Corey Saric and Curtis, well, not Curtis Joseph, he played that well. The puck kind of stuck on Corey there.
Sharks with a turnover in the neutral zone. Here comes Nolan. On the back check, Klo got a piece of it. Yell back to the point. Vandermeer. A pass shot trickles through. Oh, great reaction by Nabokov. And now here's Klo for Patrick Marleau. He skates in. Cuts to the net. Joseph the save.
Good play by Patrick Marleau. That's what you do. You lower your shoulder and take it to the hole. And it was a good play. Vandermeer wanted to jump up in the offensive zone, but he read that he couldn't. But it was too late because Patrick Marleau had all that speed, and you just use a little chip. But this was the play that set that up. The tough save by Nabokov to kick out the right leg, and then the play's going to go the other way. Use the chip, then you drive towards the net. There's two strong guys going towards the net, and it's kept out. But Patrick Marleau doing a good job with Dion Phaneuf and Curtis Joseph there as well.
Hale misfires trying to get it up ice. Rhys Miller, he just eats it on the boards. Didn't like what looked like the chance up front, but boy, you turn it up high, turn it over up high, and it can come back to bite you. He's learned that.
Absolutely.
In the playoffs.
At the wrong time of his life, but it's a lesson you learn and take to another playoff series somewhere down the road.
Still lots of hockey left in this one. 2:30 to go in the second period. This is Rhys Miller, and Joseph blocked that one with his mask.
And again, the line that Ron Wilson, and you mentioned it, Randy, put back together, looking to maybe get some energy and have a good third line, you know, position, have a good line, third line impact, has had an impact in this game.
through. How does this now change the way Calgary has to play?
They're going to come out and they're going to try to now. They have to be desperate. You're going to have defensemen stand in even more. You're going to have them try to stand up in the neutral zone. And things like Patrick Marleau maybe getting in behind and getting chances may occur more often.
Here's the guy who can change things in
sure
a hurry.
Can.
Jerome Iginla working against Brian Campbell. Sends it to the net. Blocked there by Joe Thornton. And he'll flip it out of trouble.
Another aspect is that Calgary will do what they do very well, which is try to muddy the waters. I know I say it a lot, but that's what they do. They try to force you into taking some penalties. And with that power play being so effective, why not? That's a dangerous thing for the Sharks.
Klo to Pavelski. Safely to Campbell. Here they come 3-on-2. Into Marleau. Off his stick deep. Marleau centering it. And Joseph has to handle it twice. And then Klo comes in late.
Slash by Lanco on Klo. The thing here is the Sharks have to push away from this stuff. You can't get involved in this and take that extra penalty. Drive towards the net. Throw the puck towards the net. And it almost went off Pavelski's skate. Then watch. Here comes the slash coming up right there. But you got to get away from that stuff because that's what the Flames want to do. They want to draw you into a penalty.
.124 left here in the second period.
Good face-off.
Pavelski down low with Klo. Vandermeer stepping in, knocks Pavelski off the puck, and now Tanguay gets it away. His pass intercepted by Douglas Murray, and he'll clear it.
You see how Dion Phaneuf was right up behind that play, wanting to see if he could maybe make something happen offensively.
1 minute left to play in the period. 1 minute.
Owen Nolan fires it right off Mike Greer, where it drops to Craig Rive. Back to Rive again, and that'll bounce through past Conroy. Getting out of this period without giving Calgary a goal would be huge.
A good play right there. You look at Calgary now really trying to stretch the opposition. Iginla does that really well. He stretches out. As soon as he sees there's a change of possession, he's streaking.
Half a minute to go here in a wild second period. One of the finest offensive periods in Sharks playoff memory. Classic right at David Hale. Puck still in the zone with 12 seconds left, but now out to center as it's driven in by a coin. Nice knockdown by Vlasic, and he'll flick it out of trouble to center. Chichu's there, but this second period is going to come to an end with the San Jose Sharks on the verge, if they can hold on now, of moving to the second round. They'll take a three-goal lead, Drew, into period three.
And they have to continue to play the way they played. That was making the puck go deep, creating turnovers, and then throwing pucks and people to the net. Don't sit back on this three-goal lead because the Flames will and have the ability to come back.
They've chased Kiprasov from the net. They're out shooting the Flames 35-13. And Jeremy Roenick is having a game seven for the ages. The Sharks 5, the Flames 2 on Comcast Sportsnet Bay Area. Game 7 with a trip to the next round on the line here over the next 20 minutes. And hopefully not more than 20 minutes, Drew.
Yeah, the start of this game, or the start of this period is very, very important. Like Rob Zetler said, foot on the gas, continue to pressure.
Regier back for it for Calgary as icing was waved off. And now Christian Huselius to center. With Lanco and Iginla. Good back check by Pavelski. Gets it away and up for Ryan Klo. Klo just eat some time.
That's got it. Those are the types of little plays. A little detail right there. Throw that down deep into the corner. Don't need to try to make a play when there's no play there. You don't need to force the puck. You need to be smart. Doesn't mean you sit back. It means you play high percentage hockey.
Even throw it at Joseph. Why not?
That is absolutely right.
Douglas Murray handling it carefully as he drifts back. Then he gives it away in the corner. But Nabokov sweeps Conroy's shot away. Now Mahalik on the near side. Sends it up to center ice for Joe Thornton. And he faced Phaneuf. Sent it down, turned, and went off on a change. Well, actually, no, he jumps right back into the play now. Conroy up ice for Nolan. Challenging Matt Carl. And he pokes it from him, but Phaneuf holds it in. Throws it up ice for Tanguay. Now Lombardi down behind Nabokov in front. And it comes right back to the side.
Owen Nolan's dangerous in this game. He's dangerous all the time, though. This game is just all over the puck.
Lombardi pulls it off the boards. Shoot, save, rebound, post. Off the post. Calgary with the big push here on this shift. And the Sharks need to dig in. And now Chichu with it. And he sends it down the ice. He had Campbell wide open on the left.
Exactly. Get your head turned. Take a breath. Relax. Play the game you know you can play. You can still make plays because you got 18 minutes. You don't want to go 18 minutes of dumping it in and dumping it out.
As Zettler said, keep your foot off on the gas.
Yep.
There's Miller. Nice little chip to center.
That's taking a hit. You know, he took a trip to make that play. That's not a bad play by Riss Miller. One of the important things you have to do, and there's always important in the playoffs, is get pucks out, get pucks in.
Lombardi. David Hale. To Yell. Blocked by Rive. And it's on his stick now. Riss Miller with Gotch. And Marcel Gotch throws it at the net a little wide. Joseph with the glove stop, and now he's got to eat it for a whistle as Gotch stayed in on the forecheck nicely.
Very close opportunity to get right back on the scoreboard. Alex Tanguay chips it past the block off end. Where is it? Off the post, the outside of the post, and out the other side. Alex Tanguay on a four-game assist streak.
Roenick wins the faceoff. Vlasic throws it at the net, and Joseph with the glove save. Murray battling Moss. Now Nystrom out to the side. A shot by Saric. Blocked by Novakov. Rebound. And a puck up into the netting.
Now that might have been deflected, might have been partially blocked, but the Sharks' Douglas Murray has the puck. He takes it back into his own end, and then he stalls it out. I mean, you have to come back and make plays. You have to have the forwards come back and help out. And Douglas Murray struggling with the puck in the first couple of shifts in this period. Good pressure, though. I tell you what, good pressure by Moss, who I really liked when they put him in that lineup. And there it is. Oh, yeah, that goes off. Goes off a Sharks defender in front.
So the Flames have had two excellent chances here inside the first 3 minutes of period three. And a good Sharks chance doesn't come to mind so far.
Nope, nothing, actually.
Pavelski down there against Lanco. Here's Marlowe. Back for Pavelski. On the move behind the Calgary net. Poked from him by Lanco, and he had to adjust his headgear as well as Aginla comes in and pops Pavelski, but Joe Pavelski still with the puck on to Klo.
Types of shifts you need right here.
Here's Marlowe behind the net. Gets both hands on the stick now as he works down low. Out to the side, and a shot by Klo. And Joseph gloves it. Yes. And skates all the way up the slot. Vandermeer runs into Klo.
I don't think that maybe that Curtis Joseph can hear the whistle. Maybe that's what it is.
Or was he going to skate up ice with it?
Well, you can skate as far to the red line if you want. I'm not sure you can travel that far. I think you would have to actually put that down.
Thornton got slashed in the hand there. See that?
Slashed in the hand.
Who was that got him? A little late to see it, but he got whacked really good. Somebody took a freebie.
Yeah.
I think it was Vandermeer because Klo was really upset with him after. Yeah. Slashed Thornton right on the hands.
Yeah. And that's the kind of thing that we've seen the Flames do in this series. That's the kind of things that they will try to do. Klo, I know what he's doing. He's going to help Joe Thornton.
But on the other hand, those are the things you've got to do. It's desperation time. If it takes a slash on the hands, that's what's going to happen in this kind of a scenario, and especially with a team like Calgary.
You would hope the rest would be attentive enough to call it.
Well, they missed that one, obviously. Here's Tanguay, and it's off Nolan's stick and out of play with 16:06 left to go in the third.
Let's have one more look at it. Joe Thornton's coming across. It's the chop on the hands.
Right there from Vandermeer.
Right in there by Vandermeer. Quite easily seen. That's what Ryan Klo saw. And then Vandermeer punches Klo and gets away with a slash and roughing. And the referee doesn't call anything. Come on. That is wrong. Well, the referee's got to call that. And what's the use of being disciplined if you're not going to be able to draw the guy into another penalty? So the guy does two things, gets freebies. He gets 4 minutes. He commits 4 minutes worth of infraction, but gets 0 minutes by the officials who looked right at him. That has to be called. I don't care if it's game seven. I don't care if it's the playoffs. If it's a penalty in the first period, it's sure a heck of a penalty in the third.
Last time we checked, there was not a separate game seven rulebook. Maybe in overtime there is. We've seen some of those in the past, but that was the old NHL with absolute rodeos going on. Here's Robin Regier for the Flames now. We've played 4.5 minutes of the third period. The Sharks have scored the last four goals of this game and open up a 5-2 lead.
Oh, very close to Nabokov.
Stepping outside that area.
Yep.
Gotch in for Setoguchi. Devin Setoguchi has his first playoff goal in this one tonight. And he just can't get that pass. And he's tripped by Vandermeer right in front of the referee, and they let it go again. Here's Moss. Back the other way. Saved by Nabokov. Primo on the faceoff against Pavelski, who wins the draw, and it's around to Marleau. With some speed, then he's drilled by Hale. And the Flames end up with the puck. Nystrom working against Vlasic. Swept to the front of the net, they score! I believe it was Nystrom putting it in.
I believe it went off of Mark Edward Vlasic again.
Maybe you're right, but it's 5-3.
And it was a good play made by David Hale along the boards. He pinched in deep. Sharks weren't able to get the puck out. And on that turnover, it ends up going in the net. Keeping the puck in. Throw the puck to the net. Well, we can't really see it there, but it bounced all over the place. Another ugly goal, but that's how the Flames have been scoring them, and that's how you have to score them in the playoffs. Throw into the net. Yeah, off of Mark Edward Vlasic and into the net.
They're giving the goal to Primo, his first of this playoff year. And now it's a two-goal lead, 5-3, and still 14:42 left to go in the third period.
And they're looking at it upstairs as they review every goal, making sure it's okay.
And the goal is under review.
Oh. Well,
now there's
maybe it went off of Primo, and maybe he batted it in. Let's see if we can find it for you. Wayne Primo coasting in front of the net. He gets position. No, it didn't go off of Primo, but I think that's a good goal. I can't see that as being disallowed.
We don't see the front side of it.
We only see it from the rear. We don't see what they're looking
Pretty
at.
Pretty hard to make a determination.
Yeah.
But it looks like they've made a call on it, and it is a good goal.
Yeah.
So it's 5-3.
Well, you got to come out, get the puck deep, start, go back to work. That's the key right here.
37-18, the shots in favor of the Sharks. But Calgary's not out of this yet. Mahalik trying to release from Lanko's grasp, and it's back now for Marc-Edouard Vlasic. On to Joe Thornton. Joe sends it in. He scored the first goal of this game. Iginla checked by Chichu, and the Sharks get it deep. Joseph out to set it up for the D. Sharks get a full line change up the ice. Here's Iginla, and he runs into traffic as the puck bounces back to Vandermeer. Canuck, and that's intercepted by Greer. He's got Riss Miller with him, takes the shot. Joseph the save.
Crashed the net with Curtis Joseph in there because he will give you the rebound.
Stretch pass for Iginla, but it didn't click. Murray's back. He'll dish it off into the side. Lanko there, but so are two Sharks. He's still able to get it by Campbell. Now behind the net, Iginla. In the corner, Huselius trying to shovel it out front. Takes a bounce behind the net. Murray's back there. Now Greer on the near side, and he gets it past Canuck to center ice.
Canuck was coasting in back door.
Here's Greer. Riss Miller hustling to get back on side, and instead they dump it down and get a change. Regier up ice. And he lost the puck. Setoguchi's got it with Ronick. Jeremy Ronick. He mishandles it a bit. Shoved off the puck by Saric. And Owen Nolan back to retrieve it as Setoguchi falls. At the Sharks line, it's Tanguay. Across for Nolan. Stick handling through. Puck to the corner and now back around for Nolan. Gets past him to Setoguchi. He and Ronick still out there. And Setoguchi will dump in as Ronick goes off for a change.
Boy, both teams really changing fast, trying to keep as fresh a leg as possible on the ice.
Hale, and at his own blue line, Lombardi runs into traffic. Ryan Clough will chip it in. Pursuing it is Marlowe. Lombardi there for Calgary. Marlowe with the puck on his stick to set to Pavelski and back to Marlowe. McCoy really leaning in on Patrick. Pavelski behind the goal, and he's picked by Iginla.
There we go.
Here comes Calgary's captain ahead for Lombardi. Bouncing puck cleared away by Campbell. Back up to Pavelski, and he'll just get it down the boards.
You see Mike Keenan switching up some lines, too. Iginla's going to play a lot. He's got terrific cardio, and he's got great recovery skills, so he will be on the ice, I say, 10 minutes in this third period.
Sharks get it out and up to Milan Mihalik. Challenged by Vandermeer. Mihalik in the corner, dragging it up the board, sends it deep for Thornton. Joe against Phaneuf. Thornton with the puck, working Dion Phaneuf. Joe still got it. Out to the point. Rive kept it along the blue line. Now down behind the net, it's Mihalik. Sends it back to the point. From there to Thornton behind the net again. Chichu shoots one on the one-timer, but didn't get good wood as it hit Vandermeer.
Yeah, I think it was skipping too.
And Erhoff will golf it back down. Calgary looking to quickly transition here, but they can't. Sharks will get a line change as this one's tipped out of play with 11:13 left in the third period. Sharks lead game 7-5-3. 11:13 left in the third period of game 7. And you still don't feel comfortable, do you?
I never do in a game 7. You always feel nervous and uptight in a game 7 until it's all over.
Mike Greer now across the Calgary line. Mitchell from behind the net with Greer's support. And Greer sends it back down for Mitchell again, who digs it out to Rissmiller. In front, tries to stuff it past Joseph. And he covers it up. But I like that work, yep. And I like getting it to the net.
And again, this is a third line that was so successful this season. They found a lot of chemistry. Good work by Mitchell jumping in. And then go to the net, try to jam it past, try to get an ugly one of your own. Curtis Joseph just jams his legs up, gets his body as tight against the post as he can to keep it out. But Torrey Mitchell, as the second man in, really helped that play develop.
Off the draw, it's sorted out by Robin Regier. Tange. And cleared up by Campbell. Here's a break for Marlowe up the middle. Shot just wide. He had Cujo reaching.
Had him leaning, I think, to the right. The shot went back to the left. But I do believe I heard a little thump of the pads from Curtis Joseph. He reacted quick enough there.
Tange able to retrieve one off the boards as the Sharks try and break out. Murray now up on the boards, and Marlowe, a nice play to take the man there, Erickson, and allow that puck to get out.
And that's what you have to do because the Flames do a good job taking away the boards, and Patrick Marlowe made a smart play there.
Here's a coin now, and it's broken up, and here's Joe Thornton. Knocked down by a coin. And it comes off the boards. Back now to Lombardi for the Flames. Joe just didn't have the ability to accelerate there and turn that into a chance.
He didn't have the Torrey Mitchell two-step.
Yeah, still working on that. As Iginla fires it in off the glove of Rive. Now back down to Iginla. He'll put it to the net and just wide with all kinds of sticks in the way.
Fagnell right there in the crease on Yevgeny Nabokov causing some problems.
Iginla falls, gets back up. Rive on his back. Drops it for Lombardi. Now cutting it is David Hale. He'll shoot it. Nabokov the save.
Look at the pressure.
Iginla again. Vlasic trying to stay with him. The Calgary captain lobs it ahead for Yell. A reverse pass for Lombardi. He gets it away from Thornton, plays it to the net wide.
You got to get there, start beating the defense to that puck, or else you're going to be in there, your own zone all night.
And Thornton with a strong backhand effort gets it out as Rive and Iginla tangled up behind the play.
Boy, Iginla is so problematic for the Sharks.
Nabokov fights off a high one from Lombardi. And we'll have a face-off in the Shark Zone. Jeremy Roenick tying a franchise record with 4 points in this game, 2 goals and 2 assists. And now the question remains, can the Sharks prevail here over the final 8:45? And we are going to get a penalty call to Calgary here, I believe.
Nope. Sharks. 34, but I think he's pointing to Patrick Rissmiller. Patrick Rissmiller with the high stick.
Let's wait for the announcement. If we get one.
It was an inadvertent high stick, I do believe. Well, here you go. You know, talk about a critical moment in the hockey game. Here it is, right here.
Only the second minor penalty that's resulted in a power play that the Sharks have taken.
It was actually, it was Jim Vandermeer's stick. That is a perfect look at it, guys. Great job on the truck. That was Jim Vandermeer's stick on Damon Lanko. That is a call that is completely missed by the officials there. In fact, Patrick Rissmiller wasn't even in the grouping down there, was he?
Here's a coin now to a Fina. A huge moment in Game 7. Owen Nolan with time, but it's picked off by Pavelski on to Patrick Marleau, and he's off to the races against it up. Here's Marleau, and he shot it high over the glove of Cujo.
Tried to drag him one way and couldn't get it to go down low enough.
Oh, so close to the dagger they needed. Here's Ribe with a steal. Bats it up ice. Pavelski misplays it. Now he digs back in. And it's on to Owen Nolan, who fires it in for Calgary. McGinley's on the ice. And he's got the puck, but it's off his stick to Ribe. He'll work it to the boards. Mitchell can't get it. Yes, he did get it past Benoit.
Good job by Torrey Mitchell. Boy, he used a lot of speed, and that's so effective in this situation. Torrey Mitchell, again, proving his worth as a young rookie in his league.
Adrian Acoin, that's offside.
Country mile.
And a poorly timed shoot-in. The Flames.
Wilson is saying that should be all the way down the ice because the Flames didn't try to tag up. He's not getting the call he wants, but it was so offside. I think the guys far away from that play on the weak side by the Calgary Flames didn't realize how mistimed that play was. So they're bringing it to center ice.
58 seconds left in Rissmiller's minor for high sticking.
Nope, they're not bringing it to center ice. They changed their mind.
And the faceoff back into the Calgary zone to Anders Ericsson. He had real trouble getting that flat. Finally just said, here, you take it. Conroy runs into a pileup. Vandermeer off to Ericsson. Lots of traffic. Gets it back to Vandermeer, and the shot is blocked.
Joe Pavelski, really great second effort with his stick reaching in.
Here's Pavelski now. Sends it ahead. And Greer will just chase it down as Curtis Joseph plays it back over to the defenseman Erickson. The long feed for Moss. He sends it in, but Ribe gets it down and up for Greer, and he'll shovel it deep.
I like the Sharks D standing up at the blue line. Best way to keep the Flames off the scoreboard on that power play. Don't let him get in your zone.
Here's Jerome McGinley. And they're offside again there, it looked like.
He said no. I should say said no.
Blanco back to the point. Hale there. Waits, fires, off the walk-off. Tange back over to Iginla. He'll send it to the point. The power play's over. Hale back over to Acoin. On the side, Iginla. Nowhere to go. Flips it down to Tange. Back to Iginla. Intercepted by Rissmiller. And he just sends it to the boards down as the Sharks get fresh troops on. And a huge penalty kill here in the third period.
Very big penalty kill, and the Sharks almost had too many men on. Douglas Murray came on the ice, and they literally, from the bench, reached out and grabbed him and pulled him off.
Puck out of play with 6:13 to go.
It is so loud in this building right now that things get confusing on the ice and on the bench. You maybe can't hear whistles. So you've got to make sure you know who you've got. Who's your man? When you're on the bench, Ron Wilson calls out your name. You got to make sure you look down. I got so-and-so. So there's no confusion.
After a shaky first penalty kill that resulted in the Calgary goal by Iginla in the first period, the Sharks hold Calgary without a shot on goal on that last play.
That was a huge moment right there in the hockey game.
Mahalik trying to hold it on the boards, but it's poked out. And now Lombardi comes ahead for the Flames with Huselius on his left. Huselius takes it, fires, and it's blocked.
Those guys, that line. I see Owen. I'm sorry. Yeah, it was Owen Nolan. Owen Nolan is looking to drive the net. Now Lombardi as well. That speed is really tough.
Mahalik iced it, and it'll come back into the Sharks zone. We'll step aside with 5:40 left in the third. Sharks still with a two-goal lead. Campbell off the Sharks' face-off win, and he has Mahalik on the wing. Milan trying to get it deep past Phaneuf. Sharks get a quick change because they had iced the puck. They couldn't do it prior. And now Joseph has it behind the Calgary net with under 5.5 to go in the third. Pavelski hit on Phaneuf. Gets it to the front. A backhand shot by Marleau blocked. You got to love Joe Pavelski's shift, huh?
Yeah, look at that back pressure by the Sharks. That's what they have to do, really jam it up.
He's a champion from college hockey with Wisconsin, and he's showing his championship medal here tonight in Game 7.
I do like the Sharks D in this third period, stepping up. They can because of what we talked about, the back pressure, the forwards coming back to help out on those attacks.
Now Tanguay with Aginla on the ice. Erhoff is going to send this to his winger Mitchell, who gets it back down behind Regier.
You notice the Sharks forward is using a lot of chips, a lot of chips off the boards.
Mitchell chasing it down, but a coin gets to it and sends it away. Now Regier forced back by the tenacious forecheck of Mitchell. Now Tanguay will try and skate it up ice, but he's met by opposition. Greer standing at center, and the Flames turn it over again. Ribe chipping it, and he gets it past the D, and now here's Mahalik down the wing. He'll go to the net, and Curtis Joseph just got his stick out to block it.
That's what they want, Milan Mahalik to go to the net. And that was, again, a chip play at the defensive blue line by the Sharks.
Ronica Steele cutting in is Mahalik, and it's back over to Stefan Yell on the other side. A long pass for Lombardi, and it's cleared back the other way into the Calgary zone to Thornton. 3:45 to go. Stefan Yell back on it, leaves it behind the net. David Hale taking it there for Calgary. The quick up to Lombardi. Now Yell at center. Back checking is Ronick. Stefan Yell gets his head on a swivel. Spots a man on the other wing, and it's Aginla behind the net. He's tied up by Erhoff. Yell trying to dig it out, but Pavelski's got it. Curtis Joseph started to come out of the net. Now he retreats. A 3-on-1. Ronick skating in. Fires. And Joseph makes the save. Not a bad play, because if there's a rebound there, there's Sharks all over it.
But where was the shot? He wasn't picking a corner. He was driving it. Driving it at the net in the faceoff away from the play. What did we talk about at the start of the third? High percentage hockey. That's a high percentage move by Jeremy Roenick. Okay, you didn't score the goal, but you got the faceoff down low, and you kept Joseph in the net, prevented the extra attacker from coming up.
The electricity in this building right now is palpable as the Sharks are 3 minutes and 10 seconds away from disposing of the Flames. But here comes Calgary. Joseph leaves the net. They're going to roll the dice right now and go for the extra skater. It's broken up. Rissmiller had a look at the empty net, but didn't have a shooting lane, and he chips it down. Now Conroy for Calgary, trying to fight off Vlasic. A shot goes wide of the net. Tanguay will pick it up on the far boards. He'll drive it toward the goal, and it's cleared from in front by Greer. Conroy gets it settled, throws it toward the goal, and it deflects around to Aginla.
Traffic in front, that's all they're going to do is throw it there. Chips.
Greer trying to chip it out, and he does. And Rissmiller with an empty net. Sure.
Ian Phaneuf made a good play there, though. He forced him to that outside.
Here's Phaneuf. And his shot blocked. Picked up by Erhoff, and he'll bank it out. Back into Aginla at the point. Joe Thornton sends it up. Here's Greer.
No.
And he didn't get it out. Here's Lanko. Flames all hit for the front of the net. Lanko falls. Thornton diving. Up to Mahalik. And he'll send it down, but this is going to be icing. Thornton against Aginla, and Joe gets tossed from the circle.
You don't have another centerman on the ice, though. That's the problem.
It's Greer against Aginla to take it. And Aginla wins it back to Phaneuf, but he boots it around. Now Huselius sending it deep. Erhoff's there. In comes Thornton, and he'll flip it out, and it won't be icing this time.
What a big play by Joe Thornton.
Tanguay in front of that gaping, empty Calgary net.
Got to stay on the defensive side. One man's going to pressure here.
Pavelski in, and he's been great tonight.
He's got good hands, too.
Up for Nolan. Here comes Calgary on the rush. Erhoff gets to it. Now Pavelski off the glass and out. And a chance at the empty net.
goal, shoots, batted down by Tanguay. What a play!
Hand-eye coordination by Tanguay. He's a great scorer, so he'd be able to knock those ones down.
Put up behind the empty net. 1 minute left in the third period.
1 minute.
Oh, that's interference.
Pavelski interfered with, no penalty. Here come the Flames. They're on the side. They get the shot blocked. Lombardi trying to get to the front of the net, and Nabokov's got the puck. Here we go. They've added a second. 46 seconds left.
Hello, Patrick Marleau got there. He went way low and really used his body to tie up that play.
Now Iginla gets it off the boards, but his pass blocked by Roenick. Here's Thornton. Gets it up for Marleau. Center. And it's blocked by Phaneuf toward the empty net. Good. Under 30 seconds left. A shot and saved by Iginla as Marleau got another chance at the empty net. Here comes Lanco. He'll pitch it into the San Jose zone. Campbell banks it clear. 15 seconds to go. Phaneuf looks back. This crowd is going wild. Back to Nabokov. It's over. The San Jose Sharks have won Game 7, and they've cleared the first hurdle towards the Stanley Cup. It's an all-time first, a first Game 7 here, and a first Game 7 win by the Sharks. Sharks celebrating, and now the greatest tradition in professional sports, one of the most difficult for the losers, the ceremonial handshake at center ice.
We knew this was going to be a tough series. Both teams, I thought, were very evenly matched. But you saw the San Jose Sharks, as you mentioned, pass a very tough test. There's a sad Owen Nolan who gave his heart and soul in this series. And there's Jeremy Roenick. I'm going to be very interested to watch those two shake hands. They're good friends playing together.
Mika Kiprusoff, a difficult Game 7 for him, Drew. And he had to watch the end of it from on the bench.
Mika and Abby, and there's the great Rich Preston, who has been with a lot of these guys and coached a lot of the San Jose Sharks. And there is great Jeremy Roenick having the conversations. And this was a hard-fought series. The last series going in the National Hockey League. And what a finish it came down to for JR and the San Jose Sharks.
Roenick, the star of this game, with a franchise record tying 4 points. And he has another outstanding Game 7. A tough one for Owen Nolan. The former Sharks captain. Let's go down to ice level. John Schrader is with Patrick Marleau.
Yeah, the current Sharks captain. Patrick, congratulations. A series that was, as the crowd is yelling for Nabby, but boy, this was a series that you knew you'd have to gut it out, and it came right down to the end, didn't it?
Yeah, it was a tough series all the way through. Physical team, you know, great playing by Calgary, and took us all 7 games, so boys pulled it off, so it's great.
Now tell me, Patrick, that you knew Jeremy Roenick would score 2 goals and get 2 assists in the Game 7.
He's a big-time player, and he's had some success in the past in Game 7s and came out and did it for us tonight. Hell of a job by him.
You know, there's some of us, well, I think that ironically that this series changed when you got run into the boards a couple of times in Calgary. How did this team change after that happened?
Well, I think that was a good game. We came out strong, and then we kind of sat back, but the game after that, when we came out and played a full 60 minutes, I think was a big turning point for this team.
How long do you guys get to enjoy this?
Just for a little bit here, and right back at it.
All right, congratulations. Good luck in the next round.
Thank you.
One of the finest series of Patrick Marleau's Stanley Cup playoff career, that's for sure. There's Jeremy Roenick being saluted by this crowd. Nobody's left the building, Drew.
And they won't for a while.
Well, here he is. know he became a favorite in this building long ago, but here after 89 games of this season, a love fest continues here. When you came into this game after sitting out game number six, how did you approach this game, and did you have any idea you were going to have the kind of point production that you had here tonight?
Well, I didn't expect it to go as well as it did, but I was very well rested, that's for sure. But I didn't like sitting out game six, I'm not going to lie to you. I understand why he did it, and you know, Ron Wilson's a great coach, and he makes the decisions, and I got to stick to the decisions that he makes. And, but it was a big opportunity for me to come and show him why I should be in the lineup, and I was really fortunate to have it done.
What does it say for this team, Jeremy, that you fall behind 2-1 and then a four-goal barrage in the second period?
Well, we just kept coming. I mean, everybody saw the way the San Jose Sharks can play tonight. We put on an onslaught, and we just kept coming and coming and coming, put shots in the goal, and sometimes they go in. That's what they say, just put it on net, and it was a great second period for us. I didn't like them scoring in the third period, though, make it 5-3, but we played a solid game all the way around.
I asked you before the game if you ever thought maybe that'd be the last time you stepped out on the ice. You said you hadn't really thought about it. Did you go out here and play like maybe you wanted to play at least another four or five games?
Well, I really didn't think about it until the media asked me about it, but I think I got legs of an 18-year-old right now. We keep going.
All right, thanks a lot.
Jeremy Roenick, two goals, two assists.